Nice to have you back on the show. This is Beauty and the Beast. We have another letter. Dear Jan. Dear Jan. They're writing to you, Jan. Isn't that amazing?
No,
it is amazing. It says, Dear Jan, I think you should be nice to Stan. Now, that is a good way to start a letter.
I said this morning I wanted to be. I felt magnanimous to... Oh, sorry, that's a long word.
How do you spell that word? I think you should be nice to Stan, and I think you should go away and think a bit before you start criticising country people and saying we get too much. Very good point. Ah, here's the clincher. I'm only 9 years old, and I'm happy to live in the country and not in the city. If you can't say anything nice about country people, then don't say anything. That's from Jacqueline in New South Wales. What have you got to say for yourself?
The cliche's coming, sweetheart.
She's only 9 years old, for God's sake. Well, don't get stuck into it. Don't ridicule her.
I hope that you're going to read your history books, darling, because you will find out then that your ancestors, I mean, if you're part of the wealthy landed aristocracy,
Jan, when was the last time you went to the country?
I live in the country.
What, up in Byron Bay, where they smoke the wacky tobacco all the time?
Some people do.
Oh, some people do. All you see when you drive into Byron Bay is this haze of smoke coming up from the bushes.
That's why they're batting the doors down to get there. That's why it's got the highest tourism turnover and...
Yeah, that's terrific.
Backpackers.
And it's also got the biggest CES building. It's also got the biggest CES building in the whole of Australia outside the metropolitan area.
And
did you know
damn
that?
Fine
you
people.
Know why? Yes. Because they're servicing all these bludgers up there. These people, these layabouts that do absolutely nothing, just like you.
We're getting off the point, Jacqueline. See... Look, darling, what I'm going to say is if you're part of the labouring poor, then I feel sorry for you and you've got to change your allegiances and focus on the people who should be helping your people, not criticising me because I'm voicing that discontent. But I'd say that you're part of the landed aristocracy, in which case
your ancestors were paying aboriginal stockmen.
She's either part of the problem or part of the solution.
Oh, you idiot.
She seems to be part of the problem.
You absolute idiot.
She's a little twit. Now, the problem is they're really very, very hard workers out in the country and they're doing it tough. Well, this stupid little pygmy gnome we've got of a prime minister is these federal policies that are shutting down every service in the bush.
Do you have any respect for anybody? When I talk to you, you look at me and answer my question. I told you before, I don't care whether you walk off or not. But if I'm going to ask you a question, if I ask you a question, then look at me and answer the bloody question.
Why would I look at you? I want to look at the intelligent people out there.
I'm asking the question. Show some respect.
No, you are so right.
Don't keep on calling the Prime Minister a gnome and little Johnny. I'm fed up with it. So too are our viewers as well. Okay, Rachel, you're next.
He's a man who makes his promises. We have promises and we have core promises.
Jan, shut up.
Right.
Okay, good. Rachel.
Good on you, Jacqueline, for living in the countryside. I think more fool us for living in a polluted city, you know, which is full of dirt and, you know, the rat race and everything else. I don't understand, Jan, why were you criticising country people? I don't understand what that was for. Why were you criticising country people?
There's a question for you.
I'm shaking, Stan. I don't get a bloody book thrown at me every day.
Well, just for once in your life, take notice of what I say. That's why I don't live here with people like you. Good,
I'm
pleased you don't.
I live with people sane, rational and love, peace and harmony.
Yeah, I'm pleased you don't.
You could chill out a little bit.
I don't have to chill out, darling.
I
don't have to chill out.
I didn't hear what the beautiful
Rachel, what was your question?